This is continuing the journey through the Managed Programs with Nonprofit Cloud Trail, and specifically care plan management within Nonprofit Cloud. And now we're going to be configuring care plan templates. Lots of jargon, so I built this recap, which is really just a work in process. I keep finding things to change and to edit. The last video we did was looking at creating a goal definition, and then we worked on action plan templates and publishing an action plan template, which allows us now to focus on care plan templates. So we're going to start with creating a new care plan. And that's the first step in this unit. So here are the instructions. And if I go out to the care plan templates in the trial org, we find there's just one. So taking a look at it, we find there is a care plan for this template, and it's that same Klaus Schneider that we've been seeing. And there are care plan template goals and care plan template benefits, which really got me thinking about this whole question of where are goals showing up in the system. So if we go out and look in the object manager for just the word goal, and it turns out we have care plan goals and we have goal definitions and assignments and assignment details, but no, just goal. And I feel like, wouldn't it be helpful if we actually had descriptions with these standard objects? I'm not sure why that's something Salesforce doesn't do. And in fact, if you go out and do a Google search on, wouldn't it be helpful if all standard objects had descriptions, you'll find an idea that I posted, and I'd love it if we could get some traction on this one, because it would make sense if what we can do is to get descriptions for standard objects, especially when a situation like this where we say kind of what are these things. Opening the goal care plan template goal, what we find that it's master detailed to the care plan template and has a lookup to the goal definition. So based on that, I just added two more lines, right? We have this, there's a link to the goal definition for the care plan template goals. And there's also a relationship between the care plan template benefits and benefits. So these are little kind of junction objects. So that brings us back to the task at hand, which is building a new care plan template. And we're going to call it Healthy Cooking Skills. And we're going to mark it draft. And looking back at this model, we can only mark it as published when we've added everything to the template that we want to. So we're going to leave it draft and click Save. So looking back at our instructions, we just need to add goals. And we do that by clicking on the Related tab. We have a care plan goal. And interesting, we could create a new goal, which is going to create a new definition. We're going to cancel that for now, and we're going to use one that we've already built. And we're going to search for improve healthy cooking skills. So we're going to select that one, and then select, and it moves it down here. And with the priority, we want to mark it high. At least that's what the instructions say. We've also got a category field. So as we all learn more, we'll figure out exactly how to code these to make it work for organizations that we're supporting. And I'm going to save this. And the instructions also add benefits. And we have a bunch of benefits to add. So we have the intro and intermediate. So we're going to add those two. Select them. And they add. And we're suggested to add these as mediums. So I'm going to add, look for a couple more. Let's look at, we have pantry distribution. And we also have nutrition counseling. Now let's just, to make it easier and more interesting for us, let's just see, we're looking for counseling. Yeah, we could find it that way. You really do need a list of these benefits, unfortunately, to be able to enter these in a way that works to make sure that you're capturing them. So I guess what we'll be doing is going to a benefits list like this and being able to say if we're looking at it by program, although one we're pulling up here is nutrition counseling, so I guess we're saying, yes, we're going to add this. So we're going to counseling again. I'm going to say, let's go to nutrition, and let's select it. We're going to add these both as mediums, and we're going to save. And when we're ready, assuming that we like what we're seeing, we can either edit this care plan here, or we can do it from the details side and click draft here. Let's just do that. So we're going to click published, knowing that we've locked this at this point, and I'm going to click save. We do have the option to clone, which is interesting. So if I clone this, I'm going to call this clone, and let's call this nut, still in draft, and save it. And what that's going to do is the clone didn't pick up the care plan template stuff. Interesting. So the final step in this unit is adding an action plan template. And recall that this is after the action plan has been published and after the care plan has been published. So let's open up Healthy Cooking Skills. Let's look at Related. And we're going to click New on the Action Plan Template Assignment. And looking at the Action Plan Templates with details, we see that we have a Meal Planning and Healthy Cooking Action Plan Template. So we're able to look for versions. We're going to select this one, but it is interesting to think about whether or not we have versions that we want to track. And we click Save. So now we have a fully populated template. So the next unit, we'll use this to create a care plan for a program participant.